I'm Fraser Cain, the publisher of Universe Today. Life on Earth got you down? Think you'd like to pick up and move to another planet? Well, I've got bad news for you. Without protection, there's no place in the entire solar system that wouldn't kill you in a few seconds. You're looking at scorching temperatures, poisonous atmospheres, crushing gravity, bone-chilling cold, a complete lack of oxygen, killer radiation, and worse. The entire solar system is hostile to life as we know it. If we had to choose from a range of terrible options, what would be the most Earth-like place in the solar system? We'd want a world that has similar gravity, similar atmospheric pressure and composition, protection from radiation, and a comfortable temperature, just like the Earth. Well, let's look at a few candidates. The moon looks good. It's close, and, well, it's close. It's an airless world, so you'd need a spacesuit. Low gravity is bad news for your bones, which will lose mass and become brittle. Temperatures range from freezing cold to scorching hot, and there's no atmosphere or significant magnetic field to protect you from the radiation of space. While we're suggesting moons, how about Titan, Saturn's largest moon? It's only 15% of Earth's gravity, and the temperatures dip down to -179 degrees Celsius, cold enough that it rains liquid methane. Even though the atmosphere is unbreathable, the good news is that the pressure is only a little higher than Earth's, which means that you wouldn't need a pressurized spacesuit, just a really, really, really warm coat. How about Mars, the target of so many colonization plans and sci-fi adventures? The gravity of Mars is only 38% the gravity of Earth, and we don't know what effect a long stay in this gravity would have on the human body. The atmosphere is poisonous carbon dioxide, and the pressure is less than 1% of sea level on Earth, so you'd better pack a spacesuit. The temperatures can rise as high as a comfortable 35 degrees Celsius, but then plunge down to -143 degrees Celsius at the poles. One big problem with Mars is a total lack of magnetosphere. Radiation from space would be a constant hazard for anyone on the surface of the planet. Perhaps another planet. How about Venus? On the surface, it's right out of the running. The temperature is an oven-like 462 degrees Celsius, with a surface pressure 92 times more than Earth. The atmosphere is almost entirely carbon dioxide with clouds of sulfuric acid. On the plus side, it has a gravity roughly similar to Earth and a thick atmosphere that would protect you from radiation. Unfortunately, you die faster on the surface of Venus than almost anywhere else in the solar system. But there's a place on Venus that's downright lovely, up in the clouds. Amazingly, if you rise up through the clouds of Venus to an altitude of 50 to 60 kilometers, the atmospheric pressure and temperature are the same as Earth. The atmosphere would still be toxic carbon dioxide, but our air would be a lifting gas on Venus. You could float around in the skies of Venus in a balloon made of breathable air. Stand out on the deck of your Venusian sky city in shorts and a t-shirt, soaking up the sunlight in regular Earth gravity. Sounds idyllic, right? So opinions will vary. Some think Mars is the most Earth-like place in the solar system, but in my opinion, the clouds of Venus are the place to go. I'll see you there. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one. Or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.